of people around the world were touched by the tragedy in Haiti. Many were affected. Hundreds of thousands lost their lives. One person who was personally affected is former NBA star Allen Polynice. He lost 8 family members. And tonight, as the Miami Heat are visiting the Clippers in Los Angeles,
both teams were wearing shirts saying, "Save Haiti."
You're from there.
Yes.
Was your family affected by this in any way?
Yes, I lost 8 members of my family. Wow. You know, and so it's been a long road for all of us. You know, my dad lost his house down there, and luckily for us, he survived, and so that was a blessing. So, like I say, it personally hit me as well as, you know, other people that I knew. So it's been a struggle for all of us.
Save Haiti, it's a year since the quake. Can you tell me about that a little bit?
Well, obviously the NBA tries to do its best and doing anything with anything possible. And Haiti was a big thing for us over the last year, and we're happy to help.
I'm very thankful for what the NBA has been doing. They've taken a lot of major steps in helping the people of Haiti. So has the Miami Heat, you know, Alonzo Mourning and Dwayne Wade and the whole organization. So I'm very thankful for that. And, you know, we just got to keep working together. That's been the message on my end for the last 25 years, you know.
Now let me ask you this. To lose one member of a family is devastating, and you never bounce back. How did you bounce back after losing 8 members?
Well, because I know that no matter what happens, you know, God has a bigger plan and a bigger purpose. So we just move forward. That's all we can do. You know, you remember the ones that are gone, and you try to do positive things, you know, like with my foundation. That's what I'm trying to do, to help my family members and my country.
So if we wanted to participate with your foundation, do you have a website or something?
Yes, there's a website. It's hoopinforhaiti.com. That's H-O-O-P-I-N, the number 4, Haiti.com. And also the Clinton Bush Haiti Fund. Those are the 2 organizations I work with, and I'm very proud to be a part of the Clinton Haiti Bush Fund.
We're one extended family. You know, my wife is from Barbados, so the Caribbean, the islands, regardless of where they are, they're all the same. You know, it's all one family. So food, supplies, you know, whatever we can do, we try to do, because, you know, like I said, the world, we're all one family. You know, every person is a relative to someone, and if you trace us all back.
What can you tell me about what's going on today with Haiti? It's a year anniversary to the earthquake.
Well, you know what? It's a year, but pretty much the same thing that was happening last year is still going on. The people are still in rubble. Nothing's really being done about, you know, the devastation that happened last year. So unfortunately, we're in the same situation we were in last year, and it's just sad.
So what could people here do to help the people in Haiti?
Well, what I would like for people to do is this, you know, don't let, because the cameras are off, to think that Haiti's okay. Haiti's not okay. Haiti had problems before the earthquake. The earthquake, the only thing it did was open up the world's eyes and put us on the spotlight. So I need people to just stay on top of all these organizations that raise all this money and make sure that money gets there and that the money is used for what it's supposed to be used for.
So when you heard that the Heat are all wearing this on their shirts today, how did you feel? What did it?
I was so happy, you know, because I thought back to 1993 when I did my hunger strike, and everybody was totally against me. I was doing a hunger strike for Haiti and the refugees, and so I'm glad to see that we've come a long way from back then, you know, to where now, you know, people are really taking a stand.
And here you have it. Get involved. Help Haiti. HoopinForHaiti.com. From the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.